through the second grade Rainforest red carpet assembly. They have learned about its habitat, characteristics, lifestyle, and more. The second graders are very excited to teach you about some of these unique animals today. They have each written an introduction about the animals and have created a costume. Each student is about to read an introduction and facts about their partner's animal as their partner walks across the stage at the red carpet. We enjoy learning all about the animals of the tropical rainforest.
Coming out next on the red carpet, next is the dwarf caiman. It's small but fierce. It has a long tail that helps it to swim, and it has sharp teeth that it uses to eat crabs, lizards, and fish.
Looking amazing with its brightly colored feathers is the rainbow lorikeet, with its brush-like tongue to gather pollen, which most parents don't have. They have been known to destroy orchards of fruit in places like Australia. Also, the rainbow lorikeet family known as the lorini, which you don't hear often.
Amazing blue morpho butterfly. Did you know that the blue morpho butterfly is rare in Costa Rica? Other amazing fact is on the front it is blue, on the back it is brown.
Next on deck is the king cobra. The king cobra slithers through the tall grasses on the rainforest.
It's the loud howler monkey. The howler monkey is the second loudest animal on Earth. Howler monkeys are an endangered species. Howler monkeys live in troops of 20.
Next up, we have the sloth. Sloths are the slowest mammals. What is that green stuff? It is algae. Those sharp claws are great for hanging onto trees and swimming. Sloths like to eat leaves, but leaves are hard to digest, and digesting uses a lot of their energy. That is what makes sloths so slow.
Coming out next is the biggest spider in the entire rainforest. This gigantic spider is the tarantula. The tarantula sucks up its prey. They have fur, and that helps them hear their surroundings. Also, they are fierce.
What is one of the only mammals that is pink and lives in rivers, in the rainforest, and is a dolphin? It's the pink river dolphin. Did you know that they are not always pink? Sometimes they are gray. They only live in fresh water. There is no such thing as a pink river dolphin that lives in the ocean or salt water. If they are in salt water for too long, they will get sick or die.
Next on the red carpet is a flying fox. Flying foxes are actually not foxes, they're fruit bats. This critter gives birth in trees and has a wingspan of 6 feet. That's as wide as most men are tall.
Welcoming the black mamba. As the black mamba slithers, it sees its prey. The black mamba sinks its fangs in its prey. The black mamba swallows its prey whole.
A tiger eats meat, deer, pigs, and sometimes monkeys. They live 10 to 15 years.
What is this long green snake? It's a green anaconda. Did you know that green anacondas can eat a jaguar, and they can weigh 550 pounds and can be 38 feet long? Green anacondas like to eat capybaras and caimans, which are like an alligator. They are the biggest snake. They are apex predators.
On behalf of Ray this morning. So, looking ferocious, coming out next on the red carpet is the jaguar. The jaguar has black rosettes with spots that help it camouflage. They also have sharp claws and teeth that help in hunting. The jaguar lives in the rainforest area of North and South America.
Coming out next is the pit viper. The pit viper? No, wait. Pit vipers have...
Comfy armadillo. If you think armadillos are reptiles, you are wrong. They are mammals because they have little hairs sticking out from under their belly. Armadillos have long, sticky tongues to lick up bugs.
Pit vipers have tongues that smell. They also have venomous fangs and waterproof scales, which spray from the rainforest.
Let's see your hat.
Thank you.
claws in existence, even stronger than the T-Rex's? If you guess piranhas, you are correct. Piranhas live in South America in warm, fast-moving rivers and lakes. Did you know a school of them will eat a cow that somehow ends up in the water in a few minutes? That's right. Also, guess how many eggs a female piranha lays? Up to 5,000.
In the night, a vampire bat lands on the ground next to a sleeping pig. Unlike other bats, vampire bats are very nimble on the ground, as you can walk, run, and jump. Next, the vampire bat uses its sharp teeth to puncture a hole in the pig's skin, and it laps out the blood. The sleeping animal rarely wakes up, and the chemical in the vampire bat's saliva keeps the blood from clotting. The vampire bat weighs 2 ounces, and their wingspan is about 7 inches. Now, the vampire bat sneaks away looking for another victim.
Harpy eagles are apex predators. That means they are at the top of the food chain. Their talons are 14 inches long and they can lift a full-grown sloth. They raise their feathers to make them look big, although they are endangered because humans are hunting them.
Coming out next is the strawberry poison dart frog. The poison dart frog can also be called the poison arrow frog. Their bright colors warn predators, stay away, I could kill you. Their sticky tongues help them pick up berries. Strawberry poison dart frog's nickname is Blue Jeans. Strawberry poison dart frogs are so cool.
Originated in Colombia and became popular throughout South America, Central America, and the United States. Traditional cumbia music uses a blend of African, European, and indigenous styles and uses musical instruments such as drums, flutes, maracas, and accordions. Cumbia is Colombia's national anthem. We will demonstrate some of the steps to you today. We hope you enjoy the song Cumbia del Sol, which means dance of the sun.
Thank you. everyone for coming today. We had a lot of fun reimagining this assembly. You can tell we worked very hard on these costumes. We have a lot of people. It does take a village to put on a fun show like this. So thank you to everyone who helped us, including people filming today. Afterwards, we're going to invite guests of the second graders back to our classroom. We're going to share with you our Rainforest books that are a work in progress. We did lose a day. Funny how that happens around here, huh? And we will stay on stage for pictures. And outside of our classroom, you might notice a photo booth for the Rainforest. There's an iPad there that we can take some pictures with our Rainforest background. And second graders will stay on the stage for photo ops. And we can start our dismissal. Thank you again for coming.